This is home. And our roots run as deep as the love we have for this place. Owned by the same Cincinnati company for more than 70 years. And what matters to you matters to us. This is WCPO 9 News.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Julie O'Neill. Here's a look at some of the day's top stories. A new report from the Cincinnati Field Office of the FBI and Dayton Police sheds more light on the deadly Oregon District mass shooting. You recall 9 people were killed and 17 injured in the attack August 4th, 2019. The investigation revealed the shooter had a history of mental illness and had long fantasized about mass shootings, but the report shows there were no specific warnings that he intended to commit a crime. Concerns over the new COVID variant are spreading, and so are reported cases. At least 17 nations have confirmed cases of Omicron, and Dr. Anthony Fauci believes it's just a matter of time before it's found in the U.S. Tri-state health leaders we spoke to call it something to watch. They say they're not doing anything differently, and we should not either. Today, we will learn the first winners of Ohio's Vax to School drawing. Last night was the deadline for the second round of 75 $10,000 winners in the grand prize, five $100,000 scholarships to Ohio colleges and universities. The first winners of the smaller prizes were to be announced at 3:30 today on Twitter and Instagram. The grand prize winners will be announced Friday, December 3rd. It is a party in the Queen City after yesterday's Bengals-Steelers matchup at Paul Brown Stadium. The Bengals stunned them 41-10. Joe Mixon ran for a career high 165 yards and 2 TDs, with Joe Burrow adding 190 yards and his own touchdown. The Bengals swept the season series against the Steelers with 3 wins in a row, something not done in more than 30 years. This Sunday, they take on the 6-5 Los Angeles Chargers at Paul Brown Stadium.
Well, today's forecast is running a little cool for this time of year, but at least we've had a lot of sunshine for the first part of the day. Our high will come in around 43 degrees, and it's, like I mentioned, just a touch below average. We should be closer to the upper 40s. But here's the good news. Those temperatures will be back before we know it, getting into the low 50s. So coming up, I'll break down our minor rain chance for Wednesday and what's going on with all this warmth.